We often like to simplify complicated engineering problems by neglecting small terms. But what is small and what is large? This may seem like a trivial question to you, but if you think a bit deeper, the answer is not that obvious. Take for example the question here. We have t equals 10 minus 3. Is that a small time? What do you think? Well, actually, it is a nasty question because it is completely impossible to answer. A time requires a unit, time as a dimension. So as long as you don't have a unit, you cannot answer the question at all. If we are looking, for example, in a unit of seconds, we have t equals 10 minus 3 seconds, or if we would have our unit centuries, our time t equals 10 minus 3 in centuries becomes approximately 35 days. And again, the question, is that a small time or a large time? Well, actually, we need another ingredient. We need to look at what scale we are looking. If you are looking, for example, at the characteristic scale of a human life, which is about 80 years, or if your characteristic scale is the scale of the lifespan of a fly, a mayfly, which is approximately 20 hours. So if you want to answer the question whether the time is small or large, you always have to do that with respect to some characteristic time scale. In order to do that, we introduce a dimensionless time, t star, which is the time with dimensions, t, divided by the characteristic time you have chosen. So, for example, in the example of the 35 days, is that a small or large time? Well, you then have your 35 days, and you divide it by the 80 years. And you convert to proper units, because you have 365 days per year, so you see now all units cancel out. And you get 35 divided by 80 over 365, which is approximately 1.2 times 10 minus 3, which is now a dimensionless quantity. So now you can say whether this is a small or large quantity, because now it doesn't have units anymore, it's dimensionless. And you see it's a pretty small number. Then, if you do the same for our mayfly, so you have the dimensionless time t star equals t divided by its characteristic time, which is now 20 hours, you get 35 days divided by 20 hours. You want to non-dimensionalize, so you use it, you have 24 hours in a day. And what you get, if you compute this, is 42, which is not small at all. So you see, is my t equals 10 minus 3 small? Well, it depends. First of all, you have to know with respect to which unit you are talking, and then you have to look at what characteristic scale you are looking. So, how can you answer such a question about big or small in general? You have to be really careful here. First of all, do you have dimensions? And if so, what are the corresponding units? Second question, at what characteristic scale are you looking? 35 days can be either small if you look at the human lifespan or large if you look at our poor fly. So you have to look at the scale, and the proper way to do it is to introduce so-called dimensionless quantities where you divide your time by your characteristic time in order to get some dimensionless quantity, and from dimensionless quantities you can judge whether they are small or large.